Hello everyone. Today, I'll walk you through the scalability and usability enhancements in Sophos Firewall version 21. In this video, I'll cover VPN UX enhancements, site-to-site VPN, Google authentication, and updates to static and dynamic route management, all designed to enhance performance and streamline operations for administrators. Let's first look at the VPN UX enhancements. In SFOS V21, the firewall now features bulk activation and deactivation for connections, streamlining management tasks. In the site-to-site VPN, select the connection you wish to change. Then select the deactivation button and press OK to proceed. The banner indicates deactivation has successfully completed. Firewall V21 also features improved filtering on the VPN management page, making it easier for users to navigate and access information across multiple pages. Next, support for free text and value-based search has been added to the VPN configuration. Let's explore this by selecting one of the VPNs. Under Local Subnet, I'll add a new item and search for 20.20, and right away, options appear, making it easier to find networks, subnets, and users for both remote access and site-to-site VPNs. In addition to the VLAN and red filter, the interface page now includes a filter for XFRM interfaces. This enhancement simplifies managing and locating relevant interfaces for RB VPNs, addressing challenges that occur when VPNs were built over VLAN and WAN interfaces. Along with the UX enhancements, we've introduced the long-awaited feature of DHCP relays over XFRM tunnel interfaces. Now, admins can implement DHCP relays over tunnel interfaces for servers located behind remote firewalls. Previously, in SD-WAN deployments, DHCP relay over tunnel interface wasn't possible, necessitating policy-based VPNs for specific use cases. Please note that in this release, Sophos Firewall supports DHCP relays to servers behind the firewall. However, firewall interfaces configured as DHCP servers don't support tunnel interfaces. We've also optimized IPsec VPN performance for FQDN-based remote gateways, enhancing distributed scalability. Previously, administrators had to configure the remote gateway using FQDNs, as wildcard entries were not allowed. In high DNS latency environments, FQDN resolutions could stall the entire VPN process, affecting other VPN connections. Administrators can now choose to use the resolved IP address in the configuration instead of relying on FQDN resolutions by the VPN service. This CLI option is disabled by default to prevent any unintended behavior changes during migration. To enable, in your console, use the following command line. However, it's important to note that switching from FQDN to IP will result in SFOS performing a relookup every 5 minutes for any IP changes associated with the FQDN. If an IP change occurs, it may take a while for the specific connection to recover. We've also enhanced performance in SD-WAN and IPsec VPN scale deployments by improving interface restoration speeds by up to 20 times during service restarts, appliance reboots, or HA failover scenarios. These enhancements significantly reduce the time needed during tunnel flap and reboot to restore network connectivity compared to previous versions. Now let's move on to Google Workspace authentication. In response to the growing adoption of Google Workspace and the demand for integration with firewalls, this release introduces support for integrating Google Workspace using a regular LDAP client. Future releases will also support Google Workspace SSO integration. Additionally, Google Chromebook SSO is now compatible with LDAP type servers, which were previously limited to Active Directory. This enhancement will enable SSO functionality over Google LDAP integration in deployments using Chromebooks. Google Workspace does not require a domain for AAA request, so it is recommended to provide the username without the domain during authentication. Additionally, ensure that the append-based DN checkbox is not selected by the server configuration page. It is important to note that the Google Workspace integration via the existing LDAP client workflow is designed for single DN environments. SFOS V21 also brings significant performance improvements in SSO request handling, addressing challenges in deployment with multiple SSO mechanisms like STAS, Radius SSO, or Synchronized User ID. Previously, these setups could overwhelm the server, as all SSO methods would attempt to log in the same user simultaneously, affecting AAA request handling. The enhancement allows the Sophos firewall to effectively manage thousands of simultaneous login requests, even in environments utilizing a mix of STAS, Radius SSO, and synchronized user ID. With this update, the server can process requests up to 4 times faster, and effectively discard duplicate requests from multiple SSO client types once a user is authenticated. Now let's move on to updates in static and dynamic routing management. Routing is a crucial function in any firewall, and this release brings significant updates to the static route management page. Alongside the UI improvements, we've introduced several essential capabilities to enhance your routing management. Now you can troubleshoot and manage routes more effectively with the Route Enable/Disable feature. Let me show you. In the routing page, select the More Option icon of the route you wish to manage. Here you'll find an Enable/Disable toggle switch, making it easier to troubleshoot and manage routes. I'll enable the toggle and click OK to turn on the static route. Back in More Options, we see the clone route. This feature enables easy configuration by allowing you to duplicate existing routes while also including the description field. This helps track route information for better management and clarity. Let's look at one of my routes by going to the More Options icon and selecting Edit. In the interface menu, the black hole type interface allows for easy blocking of unwanted traffic. And with equal cost multipath or ECMP, traffic can now be load balanced across multiple static routes. We've also enhanced dynamic routing. Dynamic routing can now redistribute BGP routes into OSPF v3, while all other advanced configurations remain available via CLI. Previously, during HA failover, dynamic routing would flap multiple times to restore connectivity between SFOS devices for routing exchange. However, this release has achieved zero impact on auxiliary appliance outages, resulting in a one-time service flap during primary application failure. This improvement ensures more stable and reliable dynamic routing during failover scenarios. And that covers the static route and VPN enhancements in SFOS v21. I hope you found this video useful. Check out our other SFOS v21 product demos and relevant documentation linked in the description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.sophos.com and go to techvids.sophos.com for more great videos like this one. Thanks for watching.